So everyone should have an order in which they groom every dog. This helps build efficiency and makes your job much easier. So one of the first things that I do is I brush out each dog, if possible. This guy is a terrier mix, so I always comb through his coat to get out the undercoat because he's clipped, he's not stripped. He could be pulled, but he's not. So I always start, especially the ears, and just want to make sure each dog. I do ask that my clients brush their dogs the day before or the day of their appointment. He has a tendency to get little tangles under his arms. See already the undercoat coming out? So I'll give a quick little brush. And this is what I do for every dog. He hasn't had his bath yet. This is me checking over his coat condition. I don't get mad at dogs anymore because I refused shave downs. And in my grooming intake form, I have my clients. They know that if their dog comes matted, I will refuse it because I don't enjoy shaving matted dogs. So my clients just don't do it anymore. So after that, for him, I will rake out some of the undercoat. Come here, Mose. You're not gonna sleep yet. Good boy. Because he's a terrier. So I rake through. This is the fine-toothed de-shedding rake from Andis. So it's just this dog. I'll rake through his coat and any of the hand strip dogs that I do. Rake him out just a little. And then we get rid of that. So after I do that, just double check feet. And then I comb down the backs of the feet because I'm going to do all 4 feet next. So with a 40 blade, I pull down the hair and I trim to the top of the pad. I turn it over and I tap right in front of the nails. Skin just the outer edges of the pads. I double check this length. Then I'll do his nails on this foot. I have to be careful with him. He's got really long quicks. He only comes every 6 weeks, which is not ideal for nails. This is my Diamond G Dremel with a diamond Dremel head. I always check the quick with my nail. If it's hard, I can take a little more off. And if it's a little soft, it feels like gummy bear, then I stop, because then you know the quick is right after that. Next foot. Trim right up against my thumb to the top of the back pad. He doesn't have much. A lot of people go straight to the bath. I don't, because my dogs, they're very well taken care of at home. So I know they're not totally filthy. So I do some prep work first. Then front foot. Pull that hair down. Trim it straight across at the top of the pad. I'm always mindful of his position. Forget that dew claw. And the last foot. Because I do little dogs, I can either go over or I can go under, just gently cross underneath the body.
Let me see.
All right, up. Good boy. I personally always use a 5-in-1 for my prep work. Clipper. Remember the longer I tap, I use taps because these Dremels produce heat, which is can be uncomfortable if you leave it on there for a long time. Almost. All right. Come on, turn off. Then I take my 5-guard comb. Well, not yet. Next is ears. I'll shave out just in front of the bulb of the ear. Gotta be very careful. If he's got any hair in his ears, I pull that up and trim that out. And then the other ear. Then, belly. I always, just because it's something that I started doing personally, because I'm a self-taught groomer, but a lot of people will just use a 10 blade for sanitary work. But I put it on 40 and I use my 5 comb, the 1/8 inch. And that prevents the danger of any nicks, cuts, or irritation. Still gets it nice and short. Nope, he's good. There we go, nice and short. Almost. Good boy. Almost. No, almost. And then his butt. You can get nice and close. with a 40 over a 5 comb as you can with a 10 blade. And then you just never have to worry about them puckering that and ending up nicking them or irritating the anal glands. And only do it a small square around. But he always gets poop caught there, so I take him a little lower. But just that rectum. So all of this gets sanitized, and now he's ready for his bath. And that is the order of my prep work. Every single dog, every single time.